Welcome, guys, to ILW Vengeance. We are live here from Seattle, Washington, and we got a jam-packed show for you. Championship matches, rivalries, it is all on the line, and everything will be settled tonight. But real quick, we're going to take it to the ring for our broadcast colleague, Bruce Buffer, with our introduction. Thank you, Bruce, and we are going to kick off tonight with the World Heavyweight Championship number one contender match between that man, Kenny, by God, Omega, taking on our tribal chief, Roman Reigns. Both these men believe that they are the best in the world, and tonight they are settling that once and for all. Kenny Omega hasn't had a lot of luck as of late. He is trying to change that tonight up against Roman Reigns. He believes that he is not only the cleaner, the best belt machine, but he is the best in the world. But that man, Roman Reigns, being accompanied by the wise man, Paul Heyman, doesn't believe he has to prove anything. He knows that he is the best, and he wants us all to bow down and acknowledge him as our one and only tribal chief in professional wrestling. Can Kenny Omega take down the self-proclaimed god of our sport? Roman Reigns has beat the likes of The Rock, John Cena, Bryan Danielson, Braun Strowman. Many of men have fallen to his feet. Will Kenny Omega be added to that list? Now we ring the bell. Roman Reigns already talking shit, but it does not pay off with that huge feet trigger to start off the match. This could be over before it even starts. Roman Reigns kicks out. That is actually unbelievable. V trigger this early, straight to the chin of Roman Reigns. Kenny Omega knows he cannot play around because Roman is powerful. Roman knows and thinks that he is almighty. Listen to Roman Reigns talk his trash. Roman Reigns already taking it to Omega, but Omega will not go down without a fight. Kenny Omega goes over the top. Turns Roman Reigns around, but gets a backdrop for his troubles. Omega was trying to outsmart our tribal chief. That did not play out for him. But now, guys, look at this power. Crucifix powerbomb already. Roman Reigns is not playing around with Kenny Omega. Just going to toss him around like the rag doll he believes Omega is. A strong shot to the jaw. Roman Reigns once again talking trash. Roman's got to stay on Kenny Omega though. He's not to be taken lightly. Roman Reigns off the ropes. Went for that big clothesline. Got a huge double underhook suplex. But Roman Reigns pulls him in for a single arm power bomb. Drops Omega on his head. He's talking shit. Roman Reigns, I definitely feel, needs to be paying attention to Kenny Omega a lot more than he is. Otherwise, we might see the tribal chief fall tonight. Omega blocks that clothesline. Roman Reigns going for a gut wrench slam. Omega reverses, hits a super kick, and sends our tribal chief to the outside. Roman Reigns on the outside. Listen to this crowd in Seattle. Amping Kenny Omega up for this huge Terminator dive. Roman on Reigns, prone him outside. Omega getting a full head of steam ahead of him. Huge Terminator dive. Omega, though, landed on the back of his head on that concrete. We're going to get to see it again. Once again, that crowd was firmly behind Kenny Omega. Winds up, gets a full head of steam. Watch how Omega's head bounces off the concrete, though. Paul Heyman trying to distract the referee so Roman Reigns can get up. We don't want this to end in a count out, but Omega gets up first, sends him into our timekeeper's area. Roman Reigns is getting taken advantage of right now. Omega placing Roman on that timekeeper's table with a huge double stomp through that table. Guys, it looks like Kenny Omega knows he is not going to be able to match the power. And he doesn't believe that speed of his is going to be enough, so he's got to do whatever it takes to take down the Tribal Chief. Look again, that double stomp through the table. It looks to have taken a lot out of Roman Reigns. Both men just barely getting in the ring. Omega, though, showing the power of his own. Gut-wrench power bomb to Roman Reigns. Could it be it? I doubt it. Once again, Roman Reigns kicks out. But it takes all the energy in the world just to kick out of a move like that. Kenny Omega calling for the V-trigger. He misses. Roman Reigns. It's out of the ring. Roll up into a power bomb. Omega once again dropped on his head. Both men are down. Omega looks to have had all the life taken out of him. Roman Reigns getting prone in the corner. It's like a lion hunting his prey, ready to pounce, ready to take him down. Roman Reigns calling for that Superman punch. Reigns just knocked the shit right out of Kenny Omega. What's Roman? Roman's paying attention to Heyman. Heyman's on the phone with somebody. What does Heyman have up his sleeve? But the distraction helped Kenny Omega. Paul Heyman, though, has got the ankle of Kenny Omega. The referee, Kenny Omega, distracted by Paul Heyman's trickery. And there goes Roman Reigns. Went for that clothesline on Kenny Omega. Missed. Hit the referee. But Omega with a huge V-trigger. Oh, my God. Solo fucking Sikoa running into the ring. Samoan drop to Kenny Omega. Of course, we couldn't just have a straight-up match. Solo Sikoa with that spike to the throat of Omega. Roman Reigns can't do nothing on his own. He always has to have somebody come and clean up his business, clean up his mess. And once again, that man is Solo Sikoa. Roman Reigns with a spear. But we have no referee. Referee John Cohen slid into the ring. Omega kicks out at the last possible second. Look at this spear. Taking everything out of Omega. If there was a referee available at that moment, this could be over, guys. Roman Reigns with a huge urge slam right there. But Omega has the urge to fight back. That quick combo to Roman Reigns with the Tiger Driver. Could this be it? He just planted Roman Reigns on the top of his head. The Tribal Chief kicks out at the last second. Omega thinking, what does he have to do? Look at that spike right on top of his head. The Tiger Driver's nothing to be fooled around with. It's ended many a man's careers. But Roman Reigns kicked out at 2.9. I haven't seen a closer kick out. Roman Reigns catches Kenny Omega out of midair with a spear. He just cut that man clean in half. and Roman Reigns is the number one contender for Randy Orton's World Heavyweight Championship. That is if Randy Orton can beat Adam Cole tonight. Guys, I want you to take another look at this spear mid-air. It looked like Kenny Omega was going for that drop kick he does to the back of his opponent's head. And Roman Reigns literally split Kenny Omega in half. And now we got our wise man trying to let Roman Reigns know that he just took down the cleaner. Paul Heyman acknowledging Roman Reigns. Solo Sikoa acknowledging Roman Reigns. But look at the damage done to Kenny Omega. Guys, we got a friend of the show, AFW. He has SummerSlam coming up. And in his headline match, Bret Hart takes on Bryan Danielson for the World Heavyweight Championship. Make sure not to miss this must-see main event from two of the greatest. Strong words by our tribal chief, Roman Reigns, telling the Usos that they better not lose tonight. They better be bringing them SmackDown Tag Team Championships home to the Island of Relevancy. But right now, they got a tall task against them. The power of positivity, the New Day, Big E Langston, Xavier Woods, and Kofi Kingston looking to gain tag team gold. These men have been multi-time tag team champions all around the world. Can they take down their biggest rivals, the Usos, tonight in the Usos' first title defense since winning the SmackDown Tag Team Championships against the House of Black? And there are our tag team champions, Jimmy and Jay. I don't think I've seen two men that look more down to business than the Usos tonight. They look like they're not here to play games. They're here to regain them championships. There we are. That's what this is all for, them SmackDown Tag Team Championships. And like I said, the Usos just gained those at our last pay-per-view battleground against the House of Black. And now the New Day Rock chants are going hard through Seattle. Who's going to get the upper hand? Kofi Kingston with a go-behind. Takes Jey Uso down right away. It looks like Kofi Kingston is, of course, going to try to keep the pace up in this match. You'd think the Usos are going to try to slow down the quicker pace. New Day. Jey Uso already going for a tag, but gets caught up by Kofi Kingston. Kofi's got the leg, but a nice enziguri to get out of that predicament. Jey Uso gets the tag to Jimmy. Kofi gets the tag to Xavier Woods. We're already getting a hot tag. There we go. Xavier Woods gaining momentum, knocking Jimmy Uso down flat on his ass. Xavier Woods looks to be going for a suplex, but Jimmy Uso reverses into a suplex of his own, straight into a headlock takeover. Can Xavier Woods escape? A little soon to be going for a submission, calling it over. And of course, Xavier Woods sits out with the jawbreaker, taking Jimmy Uso down to one knee, drop kick. Jey Uso grabs the ankle of Xavier Woods, causing Jimmy to be able to connect with a super kick, and another super kick. Xavier Woods falls flat on his face. Jimmy Uso with the tag. Usos went for their patented back body drop into a neck breaker, but Xavier Woods reverses into a, I don't even know what to call that, guys. That was just crazy. Kofi Kingston coming in hot with a splash to the corner. Jey Uso is no longer the legal man. Right now, legal men, I believe, are Kofi Kingston and Jimmy. No, excuse me. It's Kofi and Jay. The Jey Uso with the suicide dive takes down Kofi. But here's that replay of that, like, flatliner into a power slam, causing Jimmy Uso to even attack his own brother on accident. Xavier Woods goes for a crossbody, gets caught with a huge Samoan drop on the outside, but Kofi Kingston, double foot stomp to the chest of Jey Uso, taking him down as well. This match has been non-stop action since the get-go. Kofi rolling, Jey Uso in the ring. Can he get the upper hand? Huge drop kick to the face sends Jey back down to his back down on the mat. Kofi Kingston going off the ropes, looks to be going for that boom drop. Can he connect? And he does, rolls through. Jimmy Uso out of nowhere with a huge spear, taking a page out of Roman Reigns' book. But here comes Xavier Woods, rolls through the middle rope, clothesline both men to the outside. Holy shit, this match just gets better and better. Jey Uso with that step down, uppercut. But Kofi rolled through, connected with a big trouble in paradise. Could this be it? He's won world titles with that. But Jimmy Uso with the save. Guys, take a look at that one more time. Uppercut. Kofi spins through. Trouble in paradise. Looks like Jey Uso was out cold. Xavier Woods bringing Jimmy to the outside. Goes for a punch. Jimmy connects with a super kick. Jey Uso in the ring. Connects with Kofi Kingston with a huge Superman punch. Uso's going for follow-up back to black. Back to back, Uso splashes. Xavier Woods, though, sends Jey Uso off the top rope into the barricade. SOS. Followed by that big elbow by Xavier Woods. Can Kofi Kingston get it? Jey Uso reverses the roll-up. Sends Xavier Wood outside the ring. And we got still your SmackDown Tag Team Champions, Jimmy and Jey, the Usos. They stole this one, guys. It looked like Kofi and Xavier had it. There you see Kofi Kingston arguing with the ref, trying to say that his shoulders were not down. That was not three. But still your tag team champions, Jimmy and Jey, the Usos of the Bloodline. Guys, and up next we have Jon Moxley versus Kurt Angle. Welcome back, guys. We are back for IOW Pro Wrestling. This is Vengeance, and we have a special treat for you. It has just been announced that Kurt Angle versus Jon Moxley for the FTW Championship will be held under Bloodsport rules, meaning there are no pinfalls. Only submissions and knockouts apply. And there is our Olympic gold medalist, Kurt Angle, coming out for this contest. He is ready for business. He is not playing no games. Moxley wants to claim that he is the best pure wrestler in this sport today. But Kurt Angle won the Olympics with a broken freaking neck, and he is prepared to show Moxley what professional wrestling is all about. But there's that man, Taz. Taz is taking not only Jon Moxley under his wing, but his son Hook and Chad Gable, and is trying to teach them the art of submission, the art of professional wrestling, as Taz has seen it. Taz, in his debut back in the WWF, actually put Kurt Angle to sleep. Can Jon Moxley do the same tonight? And guys, we're getting off to a start. Angle, though, with a quick ankle pick, showing Moxley how easy that ankle lock can be applied. Moxley went with that big clothesline, missed. Angle was going to suplex Moxley down to the floor, but them elbows come back. Nice suplex counter by Jon Moxley. Now he's working that shoulder. trying to get that shoulder out of place. No strength for Angle. It would make it very hard for him to hit that angle slam or even lock in the angle lock. Moxley really torquing that shoulder back. But Angle looks to be rolling him through. Remember, guys, there are no pinfalls. With that gut punch suplex on the apron is no joke. We're going to get a look at that one more time. Angle reverses that armbar with a huge gut punch suplex on the apron of the ring. There, Moxley showing the effects. But Angle with a crossbody to the back of John Moxley's head. Nice shades of Josh Alexander from TNA. He took huge inspiration from Angle, but Angle just got dropped on the top of his head by Moxley. These men are running 100 miles an hour, literally kicking the shit out of each other. Guys, this is as close to MMA as you'll get in our sport. Bloodsport is no joke. Real fighting by real men. These two are professionals, and they are kicking the shit out of each other. Moxley has that front face lock, but Angle with the Northern Lights suplex for the reversal. Angle going for the belly-to-belly over-the-head suplex. And now going right back to a submission is working the back and shoulders of John Moxley, wearing him down. I don't think Moxley is going to tap out to this or say he quits, but this will definitely wear the man down to where it's easy to get that knockout or that submission. Moxley working his way out. But Angle goes for a German, but Moxley wiggles his way out, and Angle drops him on his head anyways. Picks Mox up for a second. Moxley landed right on his head. But now Angle, angry to the crowd. This is where Angle should be. Moxley getting up. Middle finger to Kurt Angle, antagonizing the Olympic gold medalist. Smack to the face. He's telling Angle he wants a piece. But Moxley smacking the shit out of Angle, back and forth, left, right, left. Huge King Kong lariat sends Angle down to the mat. What's Moxley going for? He's sizing Angle up. Could it be for that regal knee? Moxley from across the ring. Knee to the face. Both men sent to the floor. Holy shit. Is right the crowd telling us how it is. We're going to get another look at that. Look at this huge regal knee from across the ring. Connects with Angle's jaw, but Moxley lands up against the barricade. Both men are to their feet. Moxley's got a chair. This is Angle ducks again. John Moxley just hit a crowd member with a fucking chair. And Kurt Angle just hit a huge somersault dive to the outside, taking advantage of Moxley's mistake. The straps are going down, and Kurt Angle is ready to take down John Moxley with a huge Angle slam. Angle calling for another. Angle could be trying to end this, sizing up Mox. But Moxley, with a cutter out of nowhere, goes right into that bulldog choke. Moxley, I thought it was over after that Angle slam. Usually, when Angle takes them straps down, it is over. But Moxley was having none of that tonight. Moxley with a mistake, leaving that ankle right there, able to be picked by the Olympic gold medalist. Now we got Moxley writhing in pain, screaming, yelling, trying to get out. Will this be it? Will Moxley tap out? Will Moxley submit? Or will Kurt Angle break the ankle? No, Moxley gets out. But Moxley holding that ankle, he's in a lot of pain. Chop block. But Taz over there to give some support, some advice to Moxley. What's Angle doing? He's got them steps in the ring. Huge King Kong lariat takes the head off of Kurt Angle. Angle gets X-plexed on the steel stairs by John Moxley, and it doesn't look like Moxley's done. Moxley picks Angle up with a huge fucking power driver on the neck and shoulders on them steel steps. Angle could be done. Guys, while the ref checks on Kurt, let's take another look. That lariat took the head off of Angle. Moxley follows up with an X-plex on the steel stairs. Keep in mind, guys, Angle's neck has been surgically repaired multiple times. And to capitalize, the cherry on top, Moxley pow drove Angle on them steel steps. But what's this? That's Hangman Adam Page. The winner of this match gets a shot against Adam Page at the next pay-per-view. Moxley isn't taking no for an answer. He just put Kurt Angle to sleep with the Taz mission. That's definitely got to be a statement to both Hangman Page and Kurt Angle. He is the best pro wrestler in the world. We are back, guys, live here for the World Heavyweight Championship contest between that man, Adam Cole, baby, and the Viper, Randy Orton. And this man, Adam Cole, has been in one heck of a run ever since right before WrestleMania, when he decided to take out one of his Undisputed Era brethren, Bobby Fish, and then target his other former friend and member of the Undisputed Era, Kyle O'Reilly, at WrestleMania. Adam Cole calling himself the Devil, just like MJF. But this man has been up to more devilish activities, and he has targeted the World Heavyweight Champion, Randy Orton. And there he goes, striking that signature Orton pose, taunting the Viper, the Legend Killer, turned legend, Randy Orton, our World Heavyweight Champion. Right there he is. The Viper, I don't think, has ever looked more ready for a match in his life. He's beaten the likes of John Moxley and Roman Reigns in this title reign. Will he add Adam Cole to the list? There he is, striking that pose, letting us know he is the World Heavyweight Champion. But Adam Cole has something to prove. Look at him, cocky as always, the Panama Playboy. Stares down the Viper, and that's what this is for, guys. John Cole holding up that World Heavyweight Championship. The crowd has been electric, but here we start this off. Adam Cole starts off by taunting the Viper, hiding behind the referee and them ropes. But Adam Cole can't hide forever, guys. But for now, he gets that cheap shot in. Now he's trying to slow down the Viper, which I don't think is very smart, seeing as how Adam Cole definitely has the speed advantage. Orton usually tries to maintain the pace, and maintain the pace he is, you can't beat Orton at his own game. And here comes the show, just what I was talking about. You can't slow down the pace with Randy Orton, because that's what he wants. He wants that pace slowed down. He wants it to his tempo so he can get ready to strike. But Adam Cole with a quick roll up. Will this be it? Orton's not, he's not going to let it go that easy. Adam Cole bounces off the ropes, but Orton with that signature power slam out of nowhere. Just like many moves in Orton's arsenal, they come from out of nowhere. But Adam Cole with that swift reversal, dropping Randy Orton on that knee, followed up by a super kick, bounces off the ropes, big boot to the side of the chin, and a backstabber. Adam Cole is on fire already. Could he be going for that Panama Sunrise? It's a little early, but will he connect? Orton with the reversal into the back body drop, sending Adam Cole to the ground. And he's going to keep sending Adam Cole to the ground with these back-to-back clotheslines. But Orton pandering to the crowd. Will that be his biggest mistake? Or is the Viper on top? Super kick to the knee, super kick to the chin. Adam Cole getting back the upper hand. Orton rolls out to the outside. Adam Cole goes to suplex Orton in. Orton reversed it. Adam Cole reversed it. We're going for a German suplex on the outside of the ring. Can Adam Cole connect? Orton seemed to reverse it, but Adam Cole connects with a huge German suplex on that ring apron. As we're going to get another look at that. Look at these two trading reversals. Back and forward. It looked like Adam Cole was going to do a huge German suplex onto the outside floor. But as soon as Orton feels like he got the upper hand, Adam Cole dropped him on his head. Oh my God, Adam Cole with a huge last call. Knee strike to the face of Randy Orton. These two men fighting out in the crowd. We're going to get another look. That last call, knee shot right to the side of the face of the Viper. Now once again, we have Adam Cole on the outside, pandering to the crowd, but calling for the Panama Sunrise. Will he get it? No, Orton reverses it again and pops Adam Cole up for the RKO out of nowhere on the outside of the ring. Will Orton accept the count out? Could Orton retain right now? Wait a minute. That's Andrade. Mr. Money in the Bank. Is he going to cash in? But Orton drop kick to the face of Andrade, sending him back to the floor. Guys, but that was almost quick. We almost had a triple. But Adam Cole out of nowhere with a strike of his own. That last call to the back of the head. This could be over for the Viper. Randy Orton kicks out of that last call knee to the back of the head. Look at this one more time. Andrade, we thought was going to cash in Money in the Bank. Got a drop kick for his troubles. But Adam Cole, baby, almost won the World Heavyweight Championship with that knee strike to the back of the Viper's skull. Oh, I don't understand why this man isn't going for the upper hand. He's taunting the Viper. You can't do that. The legend in this industry, you can't do that. Randy Orton's been in the mountaintop time and time again, and he has beaten the best of the best in this title reign. And if Adam Cole keeps pandering like he is, he will be just another name on that list. Orton superplex. Shades of his pops, Cowboy Bob. Orton goes for another one of signature clotheslines. Adam Cole reverses, drops Randy Orton on his knee, takes that knee pad down. He's going for that last call to the back of the dome. But Orton ducks, sends Adam Cole to the floor. Now look, Orton in hot pursuit. Adam Cole acting like the chicken shit he is, cowering, but Orton is having none of it. He's right in front of Shivani and JR. Dropped on the announce table, signature Viper, Randy Orton. Guys, look, here's Andrade goes for it with the Money in the Bank, but Orton reverses, RKO. Adam Cole coming back to life. Bringing Orton back in the ring. Adam Cole definitely wants to try to end this. But Orton kicked to the gut. Hangman's DDT is what he's going for. Dropping Adam Cole right on his head. That is not it. Adam Cole kick out. We're going to get a look at that. Andrade went to hit Orton with that briefcase. Got RKO'd out of nowhere. That could have been it, guys. But now, the Viper is calling for the end. He's calling for that RKO. Adam Cole super kicked the jaw off of Randy Orton as soon as Orton was going for that RKO. Panama Sunrise drops Orton on his neck, but Adam Cole is not done. He's gonna strike with that last call. Could this be it? Is this the end of the Viper, Randy Orton's World Heavyweight Championship reign? And just like that, ladies and gentlemen, Adam Cole is the new World Heavyweight Champion. Look at that reversal from the RKO, that super kick. And here we go, signature Adam Cole with the Panama Sunrise via the Panama Playboy. And Adam Cole had to put the double tap on and make sure there was no getting up for Randy Orton. And that's what he did to become the World Heavyweight Champion for the first time here in ILW. I have a feeling this is just the beginning for Adam Cole. Bang, bang. Guys, as you just saw, we had a little bit of backstage footage from WrestleMania, but it is time for, oh shit, that Bryan Danielson attacks Brian Pillman out the gate during his entrance. As I was about to say, guys, this match is between these two men. It is no holds barred, falls count anywhere in the building. Bryan Danielson off the, oh, kick right in the nuts. But off the guardrail, over top of Pillman, kick to the groin. Chair shot to the face of Pillman. I'm gonna take a look at that again. It looks like Pillman was going for that flying clothesline. Patton flying Brian Pillman, but he got caught with that steel chair by Danielson. Danielson, this is not like him to be going for weapons this early. If it's up to him, Brian Pillman will have hell to pay for costing him the ILW Pure Championship against Hangman Adam Page. It looked like Brian Danielson had Adam Page beat last month at Battleground, But Pillman out of nowhere with a baseball bat to the head cost Brian that match. And as you can see, Pillman is on top now, stomping on that injured wrist of Bryan Danielson. These men just want to inflict pain. We haven't heard from Pillman since the incident. We don't know why. All we know is that he is a dear friend of Bret the Hitman Hart, so we can only assume that Pillman wants to get payback for what Bryan Danielson did to Bret Hart at WrestleMania, taking that knee, ripping it apart, and costing what it seems to be Bret Hart's career. Quick reversal by Brian Pillman, neck breaker on them steel stairs. Oh my God, I've never seen that before in the history of this business. Look at that one more time. It looked like Bryan Danielson was going for a brain buster, but Pillman reversed, neck breaker on them stairs, and now it looks like Pillman is going for more punishment, climbing to the top rope as Bryan Danielson is draped against the table, and Pillman sends Danielson straight through our timekeeper's area. It looks like Joey Styles and Bruce Buffer are being kept busy tonight. Stay out the way, because this action can go anywhere and everywhere in the building. Pillman's got a chain, but let's take one more look at that dive from the top rope through the timekeeper's table. Pillman is literally beating the hell out of Bryan Danielson. He is not let up, but Danielson's back in the ring, and he's got a barbed wire steel chair. Roman dunks, but gets caught in the back. That barbed wire is stuck to the back of flying Brian Pillman. And here comes Danielson off the ropes, drop kick to the back. That barbed wire shredded the t-shirt off of Pillman. Danielson wants blood. He wants guts. He wants to take a piece of Pillman with him. The power slam off the top rope by Pillman. That could be it. Shades of the British Bulldog. Will it be over? Danielson has fight in him, and he kicks out of that power slam off the top rope. What is Pillman looking for? He's going for that. He's got a baseball bat. That's how this all began, is a baseball bat. Strike to the top of Danielson's head, but Danielson quick on his feet. Roundhouse kick to the top of the head. He's setting up a ladder. But Pillman gets off that table. He has fight in him as well. That cast to the top of the head. Sunset flip through that table. Sends Pillman all the way to the outside. Danielson has not been shy to use that cast to his advantage. Watch again. Pillman strikes Danielson in the chin, but that cast to the head is the equalizer for Danielson to be able to send Pillman through that table and take him to the outside. But Danielson back in that ring. He looks like he's poised and ready for a nice choke suicida to the outside to take out Brian Pillman. But he's not done sending Pillman straight into those stairs. Danielson taking his time, but guys, look behind. Look behind Danielson. British Bulldog coming out of nowhere, jumping the guardrail, evening odds. What do these men want with Brian Danielson? The British Bulldog feeding Danielson to Pillman. DDT on them stairs, and he puts Danielson back in the ring. Look at this one more time. British Bulldog over that barbell, takes Danielson out from behind, and like I said, feeds Danielson to Pillman so he can orchestrate a huge DDT on them steel stairs, trying to take Brian Danielson out for good. Pillman going for that pile driver in the middle of the ring, but Danielson able to reverse and sends Pillman into the British Bulldog. Can't get the upper hand. Roundhouse kick to the side of the head. But wait, that's Owen Hart. Owen Hart with a steel chair takes the head off of Brian Danielson. Pillman has everybody on his side. But guys, look, there's Bret Hart. There's the man who we thought was out at WrestleMania. He sends his brother to the outside, running, cowering. What is going on? Owen Hart Foundation members seem to be at odds. Bret Hart came to the aid of Brian Danielson, the man who beat him at WrestleMania. Danielson asking for a show of respect, and he gets it from the hitman, Bret Hart. Guys, this is insane. I can't believe Bret returned to help Brian Danielson. We are back live for our next contest between that man, our Intercontinental Champion, Bobby Roode. He will be taking on his former brother at Arms in the Four Horsemen, both Dallas last month at Anarchy in the Arena. Bo Dallas seemed to have a change of heart with the spooky ending. Right there, Tully Blanchard trying to give advice to Bo. Said Tully would give advice to Bobby Lashley, but then the lights went out, that music is Bo Dallas. And behind him is Paul Bearer. Lights have turned red again in the arena, just like they did in our Anarchy in the Arena. You guys see that lantern? Looks to be the head of Bo's brother, Bray Wyatt. This is definitely a different side of Bo, a side of Bo we've never seen before. More eerie feeling in this arena. Guys, this is for that ILW Intercontinental Championship, as you can see, ref holding it up high. But guys, look at Bo in the corner. He seems to be talking to himself. Bobby looks confused, doesn't know what to say. But Bo Dallas charges at Bobby Lashley out of nowhere. Uppercut to the jaw. Bo Dallas sends Bobby off the ropes. Looks to be going for a clothesline with Bobby Lashley. Sorry, Bobby Roode takes the head clean off of Bo. Now he is choking Bo Dallas on the floor. He's got till the count of five to break this up. Four, and Bobby Roode lets go. Roode here is very pissed at his former brother. These two men brought back the Four Horsemen. Bobby pandering to the audience. Bo sends Bobby to the outside. Bo Dallas has not let up on Bobby Roode, but he gets caught right here. Running Death Valley Driver into that steel chair, setting it ringside. And now Tully Blanchard trying to give advice to Bobby Roode, just trying to tell him to take the count in the ring. But Bo is getting up once again, is talking to himself. Tully, you might be in trouble. Bo Dallas locks in that mandible claw onto Tully Blanchard. Bobby Roode comes to the rescue, bringing Bo back in the ring. Looks to be going for that DDT. Bo Dallas goes behind. He has Bobby by the head. He just snapped his freaking neck. The ref is appalled. He doesn't know what to say. But Bo Dallas is in that corner, perched like his brother. Crawling towards Bobby. He has him ready for Sister Abigail. But Bobby Roode reverses it and spikes Bo Dallas with that tombstone pile driver. Folding him up like the Undertaker. Could this be it? Wait a minute. Is that Chainsaw Chuck? That's the Undertaker and Kane. Tully, look behind you. It's the Fiend. We haven't seen the Fiend in over a year since SummerSlam, when that man, the Undertaker, defeated the Fiend with the help of Chainsaw Charlie. Bobby Roode getting out of Dodge, but Tully Blanchard is going to be the sacrificial lamb for the Wyatts. Bobby Roode running right out in front of us. He is getting out of Dodge. We are back, guys, live here at Vengeance. And up next, we have our Raw Tag Team Championship match. These two men, Hook and Chad Gable, took the tag team division by storm by beating the Acclaimed in a number one contendership match at ILWU Live. And there they are, two members of FTW Team Taz along. Wait a minute, guys, the lights just went out. And like I expected, the House of Black are Raw Tag Team Champions. But as I was saying, come on, guys. Bobby Heenan out here with some shenanigans. What does he have to say? And of course, MJF putting his nose in his mouth where it doesn't belong in the tag team division. But we have ourselves a six-man tag team match. The House of Black just attacked Team Taz from behind with the Judgment Day getting the upper hand quickly, with Dominic Mysterio coming off that top rope. Damian Priest follows up with that spin kick. Canadian Destroyer to Malakai Black, followed by a German suplex, and Malakai is dropped on that ring apron hard. And Dominic Mysterio is turned inside out with that lariat. Guys, this action has been nonstop the last 45 seconds, and these men are going absolutely insane. Let's see this tag team tandem via Team Taz suplex into a power bomb, but Mysterio from out of nowhere. Hook catches Mysterio with that huge T-bone Tazplex into the corner. Chad Gable was going for an attack on Damian Priest, but got tripped up by Malakai. And here comes the big man, Brody King, in the corner, taking down Damian Priest. Malakai taking down Hook. Deadlift German suplex drops Hook on the back of his head. And Brody, with that big splash to the corner, followed up by the knees by Malakai. Dominic Mysterio ducks the kick, goes for a dive, and Chad Gable catches him with a German suplex outside on that hard-ass floor. Back in the ring, Brody King and Malakai Black with some tag team action, trying to take out the Judgment Day. Hooks got King in that Taz mission, trying to put the big man to sleep, trying to wear him down. Malakai looking to assist his partner, but Chad Gable trips him up, chops him to the chest. Hook still has that submission laid in, but Dominic Mysterio with a little West Coast pop, sending Hook down, goes for the first pin of the match. And Chad Gable out of nowhere with that nice rescue, saving it for his team and saving this match. Going for a suplex, but Dominic quick to get the reversal. One suplex, he holds on. He might be going for those three amigos. Shades of his Uncle Eddie. Dominic gets the three amigos, but gets a quick kick. Malakai Black trying to gain some offense, trying to get the win for his team. Priest and Mysterio, though, are setting up Malakai. Kick to the face, followed by a poison Rana. Little knee outside on that ring apron. Chad Gable going for the Chaos Theory. Roll through German suplex, sends Brody King down. We're going to look at that tag team maneuver one more time from the Judgment Day. Fluid tag team motion right there. Mysterio sent over the rope by his tag partner. Hurricane Rana's Chad Gable to the floor. Hook, though, taking advantage of Damian Priest not being paying attention. Huge cross face. But Malakai, once again, comes out of nowhere and takes down Hook. But Priest follows up with a razor's edge. Guys, look at this Hurricane Rana on the outside again. Watch Chad Gable's body bounce off that floor. we're back. Gabriel and Brody are up. Not for long. Damian Priest goes for that big dive. Chad Gable pulls Brody King right in front of the dive. Priest catches just Brody King. Gable took too long to gloat and got caught by a springboard plancha. Malakai Black and Hook are the only two in the ring. Malakai signaling for that black mass. Roundhouse kick to the face of Hook. He catches Hook. Hook literally melts where he stood. Now we got Dominic Mysterio coming from the ringside area, trying to take advantage. Guys, we're going to take one more look at one of the most devastating maneuvers in ILW Pro Wrestling. This black mass literally takes the jaw off of that man, Hook. But Mysterio right now setting up Malakai for the 619, shades of his dad. Can Dominic connect? And yes, he does. Malakai Black sent into Damian Priest, who hits the South of Heaven chokeslam, followed up by the huge frog splash by Dominic Mysterio. Guys, we might have new Raw Tag Team Champions, and we do. Dominic Mysterio and Damian Priest wasn't scheduled to be in this matchup, but they are your new Raw Tag Team Champions, upsetting the House of Black, and here's how they did it. 619, South of Heaven chokeslam, followed up by the frog splash. And just like that, ladies and gentlemen, Dominic Mysterio, Damian Priest take down the House of Black and Team Taz. And you know MJF is the happiest man on the planet right before his big matchup against Cody Rhodes.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event of ILW Vengeance. The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the ILW Championship. Introducing first, the challenger from Marietta, Georgia, weighing in at 220 pounds. He is the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes.
Thank you, Nathaniel, for that amazing introduction. But like he said, this is your challenger, the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes. Him and MJF have been linked together since MJF came into professional wrestling. Cody Rhodes has been a mentor for Max. And as Cody let be known earlier, he plans to take this boy, put him over his knee, and whoop his ass to prove that MJF is just that, just merely still a boy. Cody Rhodes showing that show of respect, but this seems to be a different Cody Rhodes. As with our champion though, here he comes, smug, confident as always, through that curtain. MJF has a chip on his shoulder. He's going to show it and prove that he is better than Cody Rhodes tonight.
And his opponent from Plainview, Long Island, New York, weighing in at 226 pounds, he is the reigning, defending ILW champion, MJF.
Cody Rhodes doesn't look to be playing any games with MJF tonight. Both men getting a good look at each other, but MJF right there is your ILW champion. Last month, he defeated Finn Balor in what was known as the greatest match in ILW pro wrestling history. And tonight, he is trying to prove to what he claims to be his mentor that he is worth being our champion. The bell rings. Both men getting ready in position. MJF quick with the upper hand to poke Cody Rhodes in the eye. Both men have been training diligently for this matchup, but MJF still chooses to get the upper hand with shitty, squirmy tactics like the little weasel he is. Sorry for my bias, guys, but when you have a man like MJF as your champion, you have no choice but to call out the scumbag that he is. Just stomping on the arm of Cody Rhodes, you can hear him out there writhing in pain. MJF going for a chop, but Cody sends Max back in the ring with that punch to the jaw. Cody Rhodes is not playing any games tonight, guys. MJF is going to want to slow this down, play the games, but Cody Rhodes is looking to win the championship. MJF, very athletic, landed on his feet, but Cody Rhodes going for that disaster kick and gets caught. But Cody over the back with a quick roll up. Cody Rhodes unable to steal the victory. MJF was quick for the counter, quick to get out of that. MJF does not want to lose his world championship in that manner. As here goes MJF working on that arm once again of Cody Rhodes, trying to set up for that arm bar. MJF very, very slow and maniacal tonight, taking his time to piece apart Cody Rhodes. What's he about to do to that arm? Oh my goodness, the way that arm bent. Cody Rhodes screaming in pain. Take one more look at this. Your arm is not supposed to bend this way, guys. Pull some out of socket, tear a ligament. But Cody Rhodes, already back with the upper hand. Drop down, punch to the face. Hip toss to follow it up. Cody Rhodes isn't trying to play this game pretty. He's just trying to become your champion. MJF sends Cody off the ropes. Cody goes over the top. Big power slam by the American Nightmare. Going for another pinfall this early in the matchup has to just be, you know, thinking, what can he do to wear down the champion? And right now, he's choosing to wear him down with a little flip-flop and fly shade of the American Dream. Dusty Rhodes, the father of Cody. Cody going for that figure four leg lock, a move that himself and his father are very familiar with. Possibly Dusty's greatest rival, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, made this move famous. Can Cody Rhodes use it to take down the devil, Maxwell Jacob Friedman, and become your ILW champion? MJF reverses it, throws him over, screaming in pain. Gets out of it and loosens the grip. Both men now slow to their feet, crawling to try to get up. MJF though looks to be sizing Cody Rhodes up. Clothesline from hell from the American Nightmare. Cody Rhodes, both men are down. If they cannot make it up for that count of 10, MJF will retain the championship via draw. MJF though getting up, Cody getting up, both men looking eye to eye, trading blows. Fight forever is what the crowd is chanting. Cody getting the upper hand. Looks to be going for a Jay Driller, followed up by a pedigree. Shades of his mentor, the game, Triple H. Could this be all? Can Cody win your ILW championship? No, because Maxwell Jacob Freeman kicks out. Guys, take another look at this. Jay Driller, but Cody holds on, rolls through, and plants the champion MJF with that pedigree. Now Cody Rhodes rolling to the outside, getting underneath the ring. And it looks like Cody Rhodes has got some wood, and I bet he's planning to put MJF through it. But guys, I want you to remember, this match is a normal match. Pinfalls, submissions only is the only way Cody can win. He cannot win by disqualification or countout. So getting that table, I don't know if it plays in his favor. MJF now getting the upper hand, placing Cody Rhodes on the table, climbing to the top rope, possibly going for that Macho Man-esque elbow drop. The American Nightmare is not having any of that, rolls off the table, but MJF with them flare-like knife edge chops to the chest of Cody Rhodes. MJF placing the challenger on the top rope. Let's see. Oh, both men go crashing through the table. The referee is in despair. He doesn't know what to do. Guys, let's take one more look at this. MJF, Cody Rhodes both go through the table, off the top rope to the outside. We have more officials coming out here now to check on both champion and challenger. There's a hush throughout the arena. These men, we're going to look at it one more time. It looks like Cody Rhodes hits his head on the concrete floor. MJF landed flush on the table. Cody's still bracing the back of his head. The referee telling him to get up, continue this match. It's for the ILW Championship. It's not going to end that way. MJF with a kick to the gut, calling for that signature brain buster on them steel stairs. Both men trading reversals, but it's Cody Rhodes who hits the brain buster on the steel steps. MJF might be out cold. Take one more look at the way MJF's head spikes off them solid steel steps. But guys, what's this? That's Wardlow. We haven't seen him. We haven't seen him in over a year. He's distracting the referee, distracting Cody Rhodes. MJF, low blows. Cody pokes Cody in the eye. The ref, though, now paying attention to Cody. Wardlow seemed to pass something to MJF, but Cody Rhodes with the Cody Cutter from the top. Guys, take one more look at Wardlow. Take one more look at this. MJF seemed to get something in his hand. Cody out of nowhere with the Cody Cutter. But once again, Wardlow getting involved in the action. Telling Wardlow to hit the road, and so are the fans. MJF calling for that kangaroo kick. Kangaroo drop kick to the chest of Cody Rhodes. MJF looking to get the upper hand. Now takes the weight belt off of the American Nightmare. MJF rubbing it between his legs and whips the American Nightmare, who once again is screaming in unfathomable pain. The crowd letting MJF know exactly what they think of him. MJF turns around and gets a super kick via the American Nightmare. He seems to be going for that moonsault off the top rope, but MJF quick with the reversal. It is setting up for that tombstone pile driver off the second rope and spikes Cody. MJF just falls flat on Cody Rhodes, and he was unable to get the pinfall. Guys, look at this one more time off the second rope, and MJF just lands it and falls right on top of the American Nightmare. We thought it could have been over here, but Cody still has fight in him. While he's breathing, he is fighting. And now MJF looked to go for the crossroads, but Cody Rhodes reversed it. Plants him with one. Plants him with two. Crossroads. This is it. This is over. We have a new ILW champion. No. MJF puts his foot on the bottom rope. Cody Rhodes is in disbelief right now, arguing with the referee. There's no way. MJF, though, is back up in the corner. Looks to have something in his hand. Knocks Cody Rhodes clean out. And steals the victory from Cody Rhodes. MJF still our ILW champion. Let's take a look at time. It looks like he has that ring on his finger. Knocks out Cody Rhodes with one punch to the skull. And the referee counts the three.
Ladies and gentlemen,